Hey, Captain Ross Robertson here. And you know, electronics have come an awful long way, just kind of like our cell phones in a short amount of time. And much like our cell phones, we don't fully utilize the technology and the capabilities. Probably the biggest mistake that I see is guys not having their transducers hooked up properly, or maybe even the right transducer for the given application that they have, and they're blaming, you know, the electronics manufacturer. I've been using Hummingbird electronics for a long time, and you can see on here I've got side imaging, down imaging, 2D sonar, and all that good stuff, but really the transducers are the key. If you don't have a good clear picture to send to the unit, I don't care what you have, you're not going to be getting the most out of your unit or anything at all. It's easy to run out of space on the back of the boat here now, especially with the larger skimmers. And something like a piece of starboard will allow you to actually separate it from the hull so you can get around drains and different things so you can still get the height that you require. Nice thing is that way you're drilling into the starboard, not your boat, so you only have to have holes in one and you can make the minor adjustments. Having a skimmer and actually placing it so that you have a straight edge underneath and kind of where the two clamshells meet on a traditional 2D skimmer allows me to get probably the best, clearest picture as compared to something that I would glue in or something like that. So I can get good high speed marking, which is a key part of my game. Being able to see those fish at 20 miles an hour with a simple 2D skimmer like I have here, but locating that properly. Now, make minor adjustments from there up and down with it, not only in the height, but the angle in order to get the perfect picture. And in the same case with my, I have a separate skimmer, much larger, kind of looks like a little frying pan deal there with Hummingbird. You're gonna get your DI, you're gonna get your SI. You can also actually put in a through hull where we're actually gonna drill a hole in the boat, and I've done that for a number of years. But I've gone to kind of the skimmer style for both because it provides me a backup and high speed marking where I'm not gonna get that high speed marking with the actual drilling in or true through hull. Now another little backup like I talked about, it's not my favorite thing to do, but having a glued in transducer or a shoot through where actually gonna go through the hull is another option. And that's a good backup in case something happens. Maybe you hit a log, maybe you do something like that, just total backup deal. That's not gonna be quite as sensitive because you're shooting through the boat and position is super, super critical. So choose the right transducer, the right frequency, mess with it because each individual application is really gonna be totally different. And those minor little changes are gonna make sure that you can get a great picture and find the fish quickly.